In this video, you'll be learning all about the Frost Mage, the best way to level up, what skills and perks to choose, skill rotations, what gear to use, and how to dominate the PvP scene with the highest skill cap character in the game. The Frost Mage is undoubtedly the hardest character to level due to the best and most useful perk coming at level 18. This perk will allow you to perma-freeze your enemies and then laugh at them while they die a slow and painful death. Yes, that's right, permanently freeze them, so they cannot move! You'll need to land 4 slow debuffs in a row for that to happen, using Frost Arrow and Blizzard. Before we get there, we have to level up. There's no secret to this, just don't waste your time trying to loot or PvP until you get to level 18 and get the perk, as you're likely to get rushed down by almost every other character until then. Focus on killing monsters, as this is the only way to get character XP. When you hit level 10, you'll be forced to use this perk, which changes your Frost Arrow into a slow projectile. This gives Frost Arrow more damage and a splash. This can be good to open doors as it explodes them on hit, but other than that, it's a piece of poop. The splash damage is so small and it shoots so slow that it's incredibly hard to hit in PvP. And also, it doesn't allow your slows to stack because of its high cooldown. Remove this perk as soon as you hit level 13 and replace it with this one. At level 13, you can try Ice Block, as it's a decent skill and the heal is nice.
Yeah, baby! Yeah.
I've had a lot of fudge saves against rogues and other burst damage classes while using Ice Block, and I often interchange my Frost Shield with Ice Block, as this is the only way to change up your Frost build without ruining your skill selection. Once you get to level 18, you'll want to immediately change to this perk and run with the standard build. This Chilling Frost perk won't add any extra slows to your spells, but it will slow your opponent's attack speed. That's it! You've made it, and now you're ready to absolutely dunk on people. For the most effective rotation on your skills, try to get into a close to medium range. If you start from long range, start casting Frost Arrows to soften them up. Once you get into range, be ready to cast and hold your Frost Spike until you're sure you can land it. Don't spam this ability. This is your opener, and you need to land it. After landing your Frost Spike, immediately chain into a Blizzard. Place it well, you can expect to stack 2 slows, sometimes 3 if you place it strategically and your opponent is forced to walk through it. Pro tip! If you stay in close range as your Frost Spike finishes, your enemy is likely to tunnel vision on you and try to charge directly to you as a way of escaping your Blizzard. Use this knowledge to your advantage and place the Blizzard with you and your opponent at the edge of its radius. If you're further away when you cast Blizzard, then place the enemy in the middle for maximum effect, no matter which direction they turn. Once you've released your Blizzard, immediately begin casting Frost Arrows, as you're likely to need to land 1, 2, or sometimes 3 hits before you freeze your opponent with a stack of 4 debuffs. Once they're frozen, embarrass them with some some crouching, to show them who's boss.
Embarrassing!
I'm a god, Chad. I'm a god. Oh, alright. I'm a dead god. Word of warning, your biggest downfall is rogues getting the jump on you, high damage ranged characters such as fighters or rangers with bows, and fire mages. Also, you'll want to avoid people who have these blue speed shrines, as the extra speed boost allows them to continue moving while frozen. I hope this bug gets fixed soon. These strategies I've talked about work amazingly well with little to no gear, even when you come up against a formidable opponent such as a magic resistance barbarian. For best effect and lowest cost, you could go completely naked, but you're better off using the bare minimum of a crystal ball. If you decide to go with gear, then your best items to choose from will be magic attack power and cast speed. We're all set to dominate, so let's jump into a match and watch these skills in action. I prefer to PvP over loot, so a lot of my games are spent searching for players and avoiding downtime. In this match, you'll see a little bit of PvE and back-to-back PvP action so that you can observe how a Frost Mage is played. I'll be streaming Frost Mage and Fire Mage heavily upon release, so if you'd like to come and watch, you can find me on Twitch. The links are in the description. I plan on putting out multiple videos per week on Greed, so let me know what type of videos you'd like in the comments.
Shit. Uh-oh. Holy shit. Gonna get blinked back. I might be able to stop him in these mobs down here. Yes, boy! That was a sick fight, chat. That is probably the best fight I've had in this game so far. Gonna follow it up now. How did that not land, chat? I don't understand how that didn't just land. That missed. Holy sh! If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe, otherwise I'm going to have to at everyone on Discord yet again. And we all know how that turned out last time.